Welcome to Mobick Explained, your gateway to the Mobick ecosystem. Bitcoin is showing strong movement, and perhaps Bitcoin spot ETFs are finally happening. But we are not interested in day-to-day movements, are we? Today, we are going to solve one of the biggest mysteries in life together. Let me ask you a question. In a game show, a male contestant is presented with three doors. Behind two of the doors are goats, and behind the third door is a luxury car. He guesses whatever is behind the door has a prize. The man selects one of the three doors, let's say door number one. Instead of immediately revealing the chosen door, the host opens one of the other two doors, door number three, which has a goat behind it. The man is then given the option to either stick with his initial choice, door number one, or switch to the other unopened door, which is door number two. The question is, what should the man do to maximize his chances of winning the valuable prize? Should he stick with his initial choice or switch to the other door? This is a famous probability puzzle, the Monty Hall Problem, named after the host of the television game show, Let's Make a Deal, Monty Hall. What is your choice? I don't know about you, but math has been always a mystery to me. When asked this question, after a long hesitation, I chose to stick with the initial door, door number one. Its counterintuitive correct answer is that the participant should always switch. If he sticks with his initial choice, his probability of winning is 1/3. However, if he switches, his probability of winning increases to 2/3. Why? It's because the host knows which one is hiding the car. He intentionally opened the goat door to induce the participant to switch his choice. I don't blame you, even if you don't understand what I'm saying. I had a really hard time comprehending myself. It took me 3 weeks to figure it out. Now you can see how dumb I am, but at least I tried. There are so many YouTube videos on this, so you can dig into it yourself. You might wonder why you are watching this on a crypto channel. The thing is, solving the Monty Hall problem has a lot to do with understanding the BTCMobick project. Unlike the quiz show example, there are, say, 10 doors in this project. Behind only one door is a luxury car, and behind all of the remaining doors are goats. Since the beginning of the project leader has kept asking the skeptics to switch, opening goat doors one by one. Those who stick with their initial door, which is sarcasm or doubt, have received only a tiny prize or nothing. Let me show you a famous example that happened in the community. A college student boasted his ROI, which is return on investment, on a community chat room right after the Jeju airdrop. He said he had sold his 1,000 Mobick at around $2.3 per coin. Given his sunk cost, his ROI was 10 times his investment. He left the chat room telling everyone to wake up and do the same as he did. He boldly predicted the price of a single Mobick would drop under a dime before leaving. On the contrary, the price shot up in the next 4 months, reaching $180. He reminds me of Jeremy Sturdivant, one of the main characters of the legendary Bitcoin Pizza Day. As you know, he received 10,000 Bitcoins from Laszlo Hanyak in 2010 in exchange for two pizzas. He later sold his 10,000 Bitcoins for about $400, making a profit 10 times his initial investment. He must have been very happy with the return. But now, I don't think poor Jeremy could keep his sanity, forgetting all about what he had done. That kind of decision may haunt you until you leave this world. I'm pretty sure the college student who sold his 1,000 Mobick shares the same agony as Jeremy now. Taemin Oh, the Mobick's founder, has already opened half of the doors and keeps urging doubters to switch. The thing is, if you don't switch, your chance doesn't stay the same. When there are just two doors remaining, your chance will be 1 in 10 if you stick. If you choose to switch, your chance will become 9 in 10. Now listen to what your game show host says. If you choose to observe until only one door remains, it could be a good bet. Yes, of course, it's because if you don't have skin in the game and don't believe me, you may avoid being fooled. However, about 10 years ago, when not all doors of possibility for Bitcoin had opened, I chose to switch, betting my future on Bitcoin. Needless to say, that choice has made me who I am today. He is about to open 4 more doors and is asking you whether you are going to stick or switch. What is your choice? See, this is your Monty Hall problem. You can choose either option or simply ignore the show. But remember, your decision today may haunt you for years to come, just as it did to young Jeremy. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned and stay excited. Mobick Probe signing off.